A museum? Why are we in a museum? Because, my young students, you are going to be artists. And you're going to start being artists the same way artists have traditionally done for hundreds and hundreds of years, by studying the masters. But how do I do that? I'm not painting. Yes, you are. You're going to be painting with light. And every time you do a shot from this time forward, I want you to be aware of form, color, shape, and line. Okay, let's take a look at some of these guys. Now, if you want to see a master of light and color and shape, you want to look at this guy. It's Velázquez. What a genius. But look at also the picture that he's painted, the so-called Hollywood lighting, the special triangle of light. He figured that out 450 years ago, and we've been copying him ever since. But if you want the ice cream of all artists, the sweetest, the most beautiful, the most incredible, then you want to look at this guy here, Johan Vermeer. Oh my gosh, what a master of light. All of his stuff is lit with light coming through the window. Look at how beautifully he's done this. You could do it with a soft light. You'll get the same effect. Look at the way he's handled the shapes. Look at how he separated her. And look at the side light coming across her face. It's absolutely exquisite. When you say you can light as well as Johan Vermeer, then you've made it. Look at this portrait by Sir Thomas Lawrence. Look at how he's posed her. When you want to learn how to pose people, go back to the masters. You can't spend too much time looking. And you know what's so beautiful? You don't have to take a trip to a museum. You don't have to fly to New York to see these from the Metropolitan Museum, which is where I got them from. You can go online. The world is at your doorstep today. And for you to not study these things is a sin. Edouard Manet. This is an artist from the French Renaissance, and they were all about light. That's all they did, was think about light, talk about light, and paint light. You'll see my back kicker right there, and you'll see he lit this with a soft fill. Of course, since they had no electricity, maybe it wasn't done exactly that way, but that's the way I would do it today. Soft front light, soft back kicker. Well, I don't know if you're ever going to get to do a shot like this one by Degas. What a magnificent piece this is. It's a huge group, and I pray that someday you'll have the opportunity to work with extras or with talent, 10 or 15 in a group. It's fun. Take it from me, it's a lot of fun. Look at what Degas did. Did he stand them all in a line like little soldiers looking out? No. Look at the diagonal that he set up in his shot. Look at the way he's got the form and the interplay between the dancers. Degas, true genius. To close our session with the great masters, we're going to look at some modern masters. Two photographers that are just good old friends of mine that I've known for years and years and years. David Michael Kennedy. I've probably known David for 35 years. And Timothy Greenfield Sanders, just a scant 20. These are the modern masters of portrait photography. Interestingly, they both work in black and white, which works well for us because it gives us a chance to even more study the shape and form and line. Look at this great shot of Orson Welles. Look at the way he staged it, and the lighting is so simple, but the picture is so beautiful and elegant. Notice the way he's moved the scarf. Trust me, everything in this shot is by plan. Everything is done very consciously. Timothy is a very meticulous man and a very meticulous photographer. Timothy's particular genius is in getting the essence of the person in his stills. And at this point, I want to point out there's a big difference between stills and movies, films, video. Stills capture the moment, the exact instant that defines the entire scene. Films are dealing with the transition. When you look at my work, you will see that there's continually something happening in the shot. I don't just set it up and then let the camera run. Even if I'm doing something with two or three people, there will be continual movement in the shot. It's the transition and the time. Film is a dance of time. And now we come to my good buddy, David Michael Kennedy. I've known him since he was 18 years old, and he's been brilliant ever since. He does palladium prints, he does everything in 4x5, black and white. Take a look at this first shot of Willie Nelson. It can't be any simpler, and it can't get any better. It's just direct, it's simply lit, he's got a side light, maybe a little bit of fill coming in, probably shot available light. In contrast to that shot, take a look at this one of Don King. Very stylized, clearly lit. The side light and the light coming along the side of his face is elegant. The way that he's captured King's trademark hair is perfect. Don't be afraid to try a silhouette shot. Don't be afraid to use a strong light. Don't be afraid to go with no fill. If you set up every shot to look like every other shot, then your reel is going to look exactly the same. It's not only going to look the same from shot to shot on your reel, it's probably going to look the same as every other Joe's out there. I'm encouraging you to learn. I'm encouraging you to stretch. I'm encouraging you to do your best on every single shot. Think about it. Compare that with this one of Bobby McFerrin. Bobby's a black man. David has used a hard white background to separate him and isolate him in the shot, and yet has managed to capture all the planes and all the subtleties of McLaren's face. I'll close on this still photography overview with one of my favorite pictures by my buddy David, and that, of course, is of Bob Dylan. David has captured the soul and the essence of the man. He has not had separation from the background. He has kept everything close and isolated. Because even though I talk about separation, even though I talk about backlights, even though I talk about this and that and the other thing, that's not necessarily right. If there was one way to light, everybody would do it. And you want to know what? Most people think there is one way to light. Set your key, set your fill, set your backlight, do this, do that. And that's why everybody's stuff looks the same. Approach every shot as a new adventure, and your footage is going to begin to look better.